Well, Gina, cameras were not allowed into today's meeting with investors, but the lawyer, who is a state-appointed trustee, told investors that fraud at Financial Resources Mortgage and CL&M started as early as June 2005. They also now say that anyone who invested after June 2005 most likely paid into the fraud scheme, not an investment. According to Jim Donches's firm, $82 million is an accurate estimate of just how much money was invested in the company. The lawyer said they still can't find any money in the accounts. The firm also says that owner Scott Farah and Donald Dodge kept a tight control of the company's finances, and that the owners took measures to make sure no one knew the balance of the company's bank accounts. They believe that Scott Farah owes at least $21 million to CL&M, one of the closed companies. Meanwhile, some of the company's investors are now taking comfort in seeing that they're not alone.
First, I felt really stupid. You know, how could we let somebody, you know, how could we trust somebody and allow them to, you know, do this and basically steal our money?
Now, lawyers say they found about 8 trash bags filled with statements at the Meredith Office of Financial Resources and CL&M. Accountants are now trying to piece together the company's finances. Aaron Kellogg, WMUR News 9.